Welcome to teachmeios.com, where you'll find tips, tricks, apps, and tutorials for your iPhone, iPad, and iPod Touch. Today I'm going to be reviewing Yahoo Weather, which I think is one of the best weather apps on the App Store. Before we get into the review, though, I'd like to point out something that I've noticed about weather apps on iOS in general, and that's that they tend to either focus heavily on giving you relevant information about the weather or on design, and there's not a lot of apps that fit both those criteria. This is one of the reasons I think that Yahoo Weather is such a good app, is that it really nails both of these categories of information. So as it loads up here, you'll see it found me here in Portland, and the first thing you notice is this huge full-screen photo that's contextualized to my location. So this is one of our bridges here in Portland, and it displays that it's mostly cloudy skies here, and you'll see some clouds in the sky up there. And this was pulled from Flickr based on my location. So it actually saw that I was in Portland, went out to Flickr, and pulled this photo down for me. I can actually turn my iPhone sideways, neat little trick here, and see the full landscape shot of this bridge. Turn it back to portrait here. Now you'll see there's already some good information displayed here. You've got the current temperature, highs and lows, what it's like outside, time. But where this app really shines in terms of information is if you swipe up, you'll see it starts to load these different panes with lots of different information. You've got the forecast hourly. You can swipe across here to see into the future. 5-day forecast with helpful icons and highs and lows. Details with kind of a paragraph view of what's going on right now outside. A map, you can actually tap and make this full screen. Doppler information, wind speed, temperature, and really helpful satellite imagery of cloud cover for our area. I can tap to get out of that. And precipitation, you can see we're midway through May here in Portland and it's still raining. It's going to be wet tonight. Wind and pressure, those windmill icons move at different speeds based on what the wind is doing outside, and you've got the barometric pressure. And then the last one there is sun and moon with what time sunrise and sunset are, where the sun's at in the sky right now, and the moon phase, full moon tonight. So back up to the top here, back up to that beautiful photo of the bridge. I can refresh that, probably pull up another photo of Portland here. Yep, there's Mount Hood with the Portland city skyline. Now, much like the stock iOS weather app, you can tap on this menu icon in the top left, and that will expose a menu pane. You can edit your locations, turn local weather on and off. You can rearrange these locations to whatever order you'd like. Tap to delete some of them if you want. And back to the main screen. Now, to access those other locations, you just swipe across, and it'll pull up all the different ones that you've loaded. And you'll notice these photos, there's Haystack Rock and Cannon Beach, it's actually pulling local photos for each of these locations and displaying the weather in a visual way through them. There's New York, Denver, Colorado, Sydney, Australia. Let's go ahead and add Tokyo. Tap the plus icon, type in Tokyo, there it is. Load it up, and there's a localized photo for Tokyo. If you swipe down, you can see the local Tokyo weather forecast. So as you can see, Yahoo Weather really does a great job of combining appealing visual design with lots of helpful information about the weather. You can find Yahoo Weather on iOS's App Store for free, and there's no reason not to give this app a try, and I think if you do, you'll like it as much as I have, and it'll find a permanent place on your iDevice's home screen. Again, this has been a review of Yahoo Weather for iPhone and iPod Touch, and you're on teachmeios.com.